गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. इन 12th स्टैंडर्ड कंप्यूटर साइंस वी आर डिस्कसिंग लिस्ट लेसन. इन द लिस्ट लेसन वी हैव कंप्लीटेड लिस्ट, टपल एंड सेट इन द लास्ट क्लासेस. नाउ इन टुडेस क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट डिक्शनरी, द फाइनल डेटा टाइप डिक्शनरी. व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय डिक्शनरी? इट इज अ मिक्सड कलेक्शन ऑफ एलिमेंट्स. इट स्टोर्स ए की विद इट्स एलिमेंट. List, tuple, set, more or less same. Dictionary also same. But what is the difference here? It stores a key along with the element. That's all. Dictionary is a mixed collection of elements. It can store any type of data, and it can store a key with element. Along with the element, it stores a key with that. That's all. Now, key value pairs are enclosed within curly braces. Now here also it can be given within curly braces. What is the syntax for this? Dictionary name equal to key 1 colon value 1 comma key 2 colon value 2 comma etc. up to key n value n. That's all. Here also curly brace we are using like set. But the dictionary, it uses key with its value. That's all. Key 1 colon value 1. Like that you can give any number of keys and values pairs. Finally, key n colon value n. That's all. It is a syntax for dictionary. That's next. Can see how can you create the dictionary. First one, the dictionary 1 equal to empty dictionary. Yeah, like empty list, we can create a dictionary without any data. That's all. Next, for example, student equal to, here within a curly brace, key colon value. The key and value should be given within single quotes. That's all. So roll number colon a number, both one should be given in single quotes, comma name colon Abhi, class colon 12th, comma marks colon 95. That's all. It is a dictionary I am creating. That's all about it. So dictionary can be created within curly braces, and inside the curly braces you have to give the key colon value. That's all. It is a way to create the dictionary. Now it is a dictionary we have created. Next, dictionary comprehension. What is a dictionary comprehension? List comprehension we have seen. Similar to that, now dictionary comprehension we are going to see. I mean, we can give some expression using this. For example, syntax is what? Dictionary equal to expression. First, you have to give the expression for variable in sequence. If condition, if you need, you can give the condition, and you can close the curly braces. Dictionary equal to expression for variable in sequence if condition. That's all. You can close it with curly braces. Say example, you see dictionary equal to, I am giving my expression like this, x colon 2 star x. X colon 2 star x is a variable, I mean a expression for x in range 1 comma 10. So what is the meaning of this? First, the range starts from 1 up to 9, because end minus 1 9. For all those values, it will be multiplied x star x colon x. What is the value of x first time? 1. So 1 colon 2 star 1 2. Second time when it is coming, x value 2. So 2 colon 2 star 2 4. Next time 3, x value 3, 3 colon 2 star 3 6. Like that it will be going on. That's all. So first, what will happen here? The range, it is starting from 1 to 10. First value 1. So in the place of x, we can substitute 1. 1 colon 2 star x 2. So in my output, what is the answer will be 1 colon 2. Next 2 colon 4. It will starting from 1 up to 9 it will take. So 1 colon 2, 2 colon 4, 3 colon 6, like that going on up to last value 9 colon 18. This is called as dictionary comprehension. We can give the expression and range in the same line. It is very easy for us to give the expression. That's all. Next thing, how can you access an elements in a dictionary? Very simple thing. First, student equal to, this is a dictionary I have created. Roll number, name, standard, marks. 4 key with 4 values I have given. when I am giving print to student, automatically the entire dictionary elements will be printed. It prints all the elements in a dictionary fully and the entire thing will be printed. Now suppose I am giving print student roll number. What is the meaning of it? Dictionary name and key value. If I am giving, suppose I want to print roll number alone, you can give like this, print student of roll number. So what will happen here? In my output, I can get the roll number alone in the dictionary. Roll number 1, 2, 3, 4 will be printed. Next, print student name. So dictionary name is student, S-T-U-D, and my key is name. Name alone I want to print. You can give like this, print student of name. So name Abhi will be printed. If you want to print the entire element, simply you can give the dictionary name alone is enough. Suppose if you want to give only, if you want to print only one value, one key element, one value alone, if you want, you can give like the student of roll number. So the roll number alone will be printed with value. Similarly, student of name, name alone will be printed with value. This is called as accessing elements in the dictionary. Like this, you can access any element in the dictionary. Next, adding elements in the dictionary. Next thing, already I have created, suppose I want to add one element, what is the possibility, what is the way to add the element? So what is the syntax for this? Dictionary name key equal to value or element. That's a very simple thing. Like this, dictionary name within a square bracket I can give key equal to value or element. That's all. It is a very simple thing. You can see now, for example, student in the, here already I have given in student, I have given roll number, name, standard and marks. Now I am going to add one more key, age. So I am adding like the student of dictionary name within a square bracket, what key, age equal to what value, age I am giving. So automatically this key will be added with the dictionary. So print student of age, it will display that age alone. That's all. This is called as how can you add an element. Simple thing, dictionary name key equal to value, automatically it will be added. Now when I am printing dictionary name student alone, what will happen? It will print all the four items with the age also. Next, modifying the element in the dictionary. How to modify? Here modification is similar to adding. The dictionary is immutable. Modification is similar to adding the element. When I am giving the new value, it will override the old value. That's all. Here we should not change anything. Instead of that, we can create a new thing. That's all. So take this example, and student, already I have given student age as 18. Now I want to change it as 19. So you can give like this, dictionary name key equal to value. That's all. Student age equal to 19. So what will happen here? Already in student dictionary, age key has a value 18. Now it is changed as 19. So when I am printing print student of age, automatically this age 19 will be printed. That's all. This is called how to modify the element in a dictionary. That's all. Next, next topic is what? How to delete the elements in a dictionary. The same thing only, like previous list, tuple and all. If you want to delete the entire thing, you can give delete dictionary name alone. Suppose a particular element I want to delete, you can give like this, delete dictionary name within a bracket key. That's all. Now for example, delete dictionary name within a square bracket, you can give key. If you want that particular element, if you want to delete, you can use like this. And otherwise you can use dictionary name dot clear equal to empty. What will happen? All the elements will be cleared. Suppose that I am giving delete dictionary name, the entire thing will be deleted. All the elements will be deleted. That's all. For example, delete student of age. If I am giving, the age alone will be deleted in that particular dictionary. The remaining, it will be there. When I am giving delete student, the dictionary full will be deleted. Entire dictionary will be deleted. So this is called as delete dictionary name. That's all about it. So now next final topic is what? We are going to discuss the difference between, that's all about deleting. Now next, we are going to see the difference between list and dictionary. Already we have studied about list. Now what is dictionary? List is a ordered set of elements, but dictionary is a data structure used for storing or matching one element with another element. Here in list it's simply we are giving the element alone, but in dictionary we are giving key with element, that's all. Key along with the element, that's all. That's the first point. And second point, in list index is used to access the element, but in dictionary key is used to access the element. That's all. Index value there we are using a of 0, a of 1, like that. Here the key, student of name, like that I am giving. The key is used to access an element. That's all. And next, lists are used to look up a value. A simple value you can see, but dictionary is used to take one value and look up with another value. Key is used along with dictionary. Sorry, value. Key colon value. That's all. This is called as the difference between list and dictionary. That's all. So now list is an order set of elements, but in list and dictionary I am using one, matching one element with other element, key colon value. And second point, in the list index is used to access element, but in dictionary key is used to access an element. And third point, list are used to look up a value, but dictionary it is used to look up one value and match with other value. That's all. It is used to take one value and look up with another value. That's all. So students, dictionary is a very small topic. That's all. Dictionary also over. So with this lesson over. What we have started? What is a dictionary and how to create the dictionary and how to, what is dictionary? It is important question. Dictionary comprehension and accessing elements in a dictionary and adding. How can I add the elements in the dictionary and modify, deleting. We have seen finally the difference between list and a dictionary. We have seen, that's all. With this lesson over, the list lesson over. Students, this lesson consists of only 4 parts: list, tuple, set and dictionary. We compare and study, it's easy for you. Learn thoroughly. Thank you.